Canada.
But via Sri Lanka. Via Sri Lanka.
Via Sri Lanka. Did he meet Hansadutta Maharaj? No. Hansadutta Maharaj is not there.
Did you meet Hansadutta Maharaj there?
No, he was in Berkeley. I met him at Berkeley. I didn't meet him there.
When is he coming?
Oh,
25th of March. He's coming here.
Rudvaga says on the 25th.
But that is the zone of Hansadutta Maharaj, Lanka.
Yes.
But how did he go then? There?
His wife's relatives live there.
Oh. She comes from Lanka.
Yes.
Oh, all right. Toronto, Canada. There was
Subha Vilas.
Subha Vilas Prabhu, yes. Does he know anything about him?
No.
Subha Vilas Prabhu?
How is he? He knows.
Huh?
Never come forward so
he can. Last year he gave a letter that I am coming with my friends to you direct. Does it suit you? Yes, you can come. I want to stay for some time there. Yes, you are welcome. But no place after that. Subha Vilas. He was the manager in the Rameshwar state. Subha Vilas? Or my manager?
Rameshwar state?
In the zone of Rameshwar Prabhu?
No, he was managing in the zone of Tamal Krishna.
Tamal Krishna, yes. Now he has left everything.
Why
are you also today? Huh? Also. You have to go to the house. Ah. Are
you
taking a mark? Yes, sir. Joy of the ভাবে
না বলে দিলাম যে এই মাল আসবে যদি জিজ্ঞেস করলে বলতে পারে
বাবা নন্দা মহারাজ টোল্ড হরি সেবানা that he was thinking that the GBC in America might have overreacted in relationship to you and the new sannyasis.
His goodness.
His goodness.
Also, this is a book that is written by Hari K. Swami.
Yes.
It's called the Varnashram Manifesto.
Yes.
For social sanity. Varnashram Manifesto.
A country, they should, the main principles underlined may be represented to me.
Okay.
Then I can find it. At your leisure, you will underline the salient points.
All right.
And then you may produce it.
Rehearsed up only to kind of win. Rehearsed up. Introduction.
That is not mere social, but that has been accepted as the foundation of theism, theistic life. Varnashram. Rai Ramananda Sangvad, the beginning from Varnashram, then it developed. The foundation of theistic life is supposed to be Varnashram. But there also the form should be neglected and the speech should be accepted. In this way, the progress, the form and the spirit, both. When they make much of the form, then that is mere social. And when they look to the spirit of it, then it becomes a dynamic thing, Daiva Varnashram. Form is also necessary, and the spirit reading that is also necessary, but that is more substantial than the form. So from Ramananda Rai, Varnasrama Charvata, beginning is with Varnasrama and then gradually. What is the aim of Varnasrama? Krishna Karma form, then Karma Tag, then Gyananishtha Bhakti, then Gyanasunna Bhakti, then the actual position in the devotional school is taken, Gyanasunna Bhakti. Otherwise, Eho-bhajjo, all superficial, all formula. Kichu bolchen? Okay. Hare Krishna. আপনি বাজার যাচ্ছেন?
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ আমি বাজার যাচ্ছি।
পরিচালনে যদি ওষুধ না থাকে খাটতে হবে তখন ওষুধের সাহায্য হরি কৃষ্ণ হরি কৃষ্ণ বদনাশ্রম হরি কৃষ্ণ গৌর হরি গৌর
And the Shiva Loka is Gyanasunya Bhakti? Shivata?
Shiva Loka. Not proper. The best portion of Shuddha Bhakti, the lowest, near the marginal region. Shiva says, Brahma shows Shiva, Karmamishra Bhakti Brahma. He points out Shiva to be higher. Shiva points us to Prahlad, and from Prahlad Shuddha Bhakti begins. Prahlad is above Shiva. Shiva is the emblem of Gyanamishtha. Then comes Prahlad. From there, Shuddha Bhakti begins. But Prahlad also hesitates. And he recites his own example that sometimes I went to oppose Sri Vishnu in Naimisharanya, I went to fight against him in Sankalpa. So I should not be reckoned as Shuddha Bhakta. I have got some this demonic element in me. So I had the birth in the demon family. He says so. But still, in general, Prahlad is accepted as Shuddha Bhakta. And then, above that, Hanuman, Shuddha Bhakta, Dasatta, Prahlad Santa Bhakti. And the next higher, Dasya Bhakti, and the typical Dasya Bhakti in Hanuman. Then above that, Sakya Bhakti. And the typical in Sakya Bhakti is Arjuna, the Krishna. Then again higher, this Jadava and the Uddhava. And this way it develops. মতথা প্রিয়তম নাত্ম যৌনি ন শঙ্কর নচ শঙ্কর্ষণ নশ্রী নৈবাত্মা যথাভব দেন কর্মী ভিত হরিত প্রিয়তয়া ভক্তি যজুর্জ্ঞানীন জ্ঞানীন মিনস চতুষ্ তেভ্য জ্ঞান বিমুক্ত ভক্তি পরমা মিনস নারদ জ্ঞান বিমুক্ত ভক্তি পর প্রেমৈক নিষ্ঠা সত দচিরুদ্ধব তেভ্যস্তা পশুপাল পঙ্কজ দেশ দেন দি গোপী দেন দ্য নেক্সট তেভ্য বিশারাধিকা and the Radha Rani holding the highest position. In this way, the gradation of pure and pure is rising up. Hare Krishna, Gaur Hari Bol, Gaur Hari Bol, Gaur Hari Bol. Manu Bhajya Samutkirne Sutrashi Vasti Vinagati. Kalidas says, just before his compilation of Raghu Vamsa, the great sage Kalidas, his introduction to his own self. Here I am, a small poet, and my aspiration to describe the great famous dynasty of the Surya Vamsa. Ka Surya Bhavu Vamsa, ka Chalpa Vishayamati. There is that great dynasty, royal dynasty that we should Surya-vamsa. I am an insignificant person. I want to describe their glory. Ahankar boast in me. অথবা কৃতভাগদারী বংশীস্মিন পূর্বসূরী মনু বজ্র সংস্কৃতি সূত্রশ্রী বাস্তব অন দি আদার হ্যান্ড আই মে থিঙ্ক ইট দ্যাট দি বাল্মীকি ব্যাস দোজ গ্রেট পার্সনেজেস দে হ্যাভ শোন দে হ্যাভ চকড আউট সাম পাথ অ্যান্ড আই ক্যান ওয়ার্ক আউট ইন দ্যাট পাথ দি এক্সাম্পল ইজ ভেরি valuable. Manu Bhajya Samutkirne. The money, the jewel, and the jewel is pierced through by first and by the, what is that?
Needle.
Needle. That big needle. And then the thread can enter very easily through that. So my position is like thread. Thread. And the needle, the big needle, has already pierced through. So that is our position. The great Vaishnava, they have already weighed and given stamp what is what. And we are only like thread entering into that. Entering through the hole. তো সনাতন গোস্বামী কবিরাজ গোস্বামী সুগ্রীব গোস্বামী দে হ্যাভ অলরেডি গিভেন আস দি কম্পারেটিভ স্টাডি অফ দি বৈষ্ণব অ্যান্ড ফ্রম হিয়ার উই আর ট্রাইং টু ফলো দ্যাট অ্যান্ড টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দ্যাট হাউ দি ট্রেডিশন ইজ দেয়ার হ্যারি উদ্ধব হ্যারি গোপী হ্যারি রাধারানী And from here, we are smoothly going on the marking. Again, he is greater than all. He is greater than from here. Sutrashri Vastini Goti. Sanatana Goswami, when writing about Satyabhama, Rukmini, who is who, then he says, it must be my audacity, that I am going to compare, draw the comparison among the twins of Krishna in Dwaraka. What audacity I have got. But my friends, believe me, I am not liking someone forcibly taking my hand and force me to like. Sadhana Goswami said, I am a thin person, how can I draw comparison between them and say this is, he is that, he is good, he has got this qualification, he is higher qualification. But someone enforcing me to lie. See, that's with my hand, my pen. So adhoshaya, that is, whenever we deal, it is the function of yogamaya sarupa shakti. So if jiva shakti comes to interfere, to handle, to participate, then that higher potency must come and influence him. Only it is possible that then and there, otherwise not. The jiva cannot have any connection to deal with those Vaikuntha things. So always this should be kept in mind. So our dedication, our surrender to that potency, that is our qualification. That should be considered as our qualification, that to surrender to that higher potency and to allow her to work through me. That should be. Well, whenever we have to deal with that higher substances, then only we should surrender, we should ask to be utilized by the higher force. So surrender is the first quality when we approach to deal with things of higher substances. Always this should be kept in mind. Do you follow? Am I clear? No.
Yes,
so we are helpless. And the surrendering is the only qualification that can help us to deal with things that are above super subjective realm. The super higher I cannot be subject. The realm is super subjective. And it is not a fashion of saying, reality is this. If we are to face with reality, then we must have to admit this, the supra-subjective. As a subject, I cannot enter there. Supra-subjective means to invite the supra-subject to work in me. That should be the attitude. So Mahaprabhu says, jnana sunna bhakti, saranagati, surrendering. Surrendering is to invite the higher potency to work through me. That should be the attitude of all devotees, surrendering. And to make himself instrument of the higher potency. As much as that will come in, only to give vent to that. No coloring, no prejudice of his own. As much as possible, the current will come down and try to represent that what is coming down. That should be our attitude. Bold, holy, bold, bold, holy, bold, bold, holy, bold, bold, holy, bold. If we miss this point, this important point to hit, then we are under prakita sahajiya. Then what will be the result? We shall muddling with the shadow. Shadow will be our subject. We shall fight with shadow. So, the life of devotion is devotedness. Devotedness, the degree of devotedness to the cause, the wealth is there. Wealth is his, only his land that comes down. It is his property. Or in other words, it is the property of my Gurudev. Gurudev's property. I am using on his behalf. I must be a faithful servant to deal with his things. And he will say, this is my Gurudev's property in this way. Everyone in the succession. So this is the property of my Gurudev. He also says, this is the property of my Gurudev in this way. The upek guru and transparent guru. The upek guru is to be rejected. Guru Bhruva. He wants to say that I am Guru. He is Guru Bhruva. Not real Guru, Guru Bhruva. Who confesses himself that I am Guru. He is Guru Bhruva. Atmanam Guru Bhagavati.
Guru Bhruva means what do you mean? Guru Bhruva
means what do you mean? Who is confessing, who is his own confessor that he is Guru? He is Guru Bhruva, Guru Dhatu, Bhagavati. Who says that he, the Guru saying that, that I am Guru, confessing himself. Guru Bhruva. And the real Guru, he is transparent Guru. Through him, things on other side can be seen. He is transparent. And Guru Bhruva, that is a barrier, hindrance between the transcendental and the mundane. Upek. Harichan, Shiki Glass Kavajala.
When Gaurakrishna took his Mohini avatar and Shiva was following him, in Srimad Bhagavatam they said there was no issue, but in South India they worshipped an issue which is called Harihara Putra. Is this bonafide?
Who is putting this question?
Buddhi Yoga.
When has he come?
Just come.
Today.
Yesterday. Today? Right. Then what is your question?
When Krishna took his Mohini avatar,
yes,
and Shiva was following him,
yes,
in the Srimad Bhagavatam, yes, that there is...
What is the question underlying?
The question is, in South India, they worship an issue as Harihara Putra, the combination of Shiva and Vishnu, as asking if this is bona fide. There was an issue, there was a Putra from Mohini and Shiva.
What does he say? In South India?
South India, they worship the
sun. Harihara.
Harihara Putra, the son of Mohini and Shiva. Is it correct or not?
Mohini and Shiva. This is the first time we traveled throughout South India. The first time this comes to me. And is gives me a suggestion that there is a class of Pasandis, the followers of Shiva, extreme followers of Shiva. It is perhaps they are created blasphemy. Mm. This never occurs. And if it is found in any Puran, Linga Puran or this Tamasic Puran, then also it should be taken as Mayavad Masachastram Pachanam Buddha Muchati, later created by some of the mischievous persons in that way. And so Ramanuja told, Dagrino Kadamanu Vinu Gachi Shiva Mandiram. It is better that a tiger will devour you. Yet, nevertheless, you must not enter any temple of Shiva. No Gachi Shiva Mandiram. So for shelter. Don't go to take shelter in Shiva temple. Rather, the tiger may devour you. I have not heard like that so far. Rather, it is mentioned in the Bhagavatam that Shiva was so much excited seeing that Mohini Murti. Mohini Murti was not a material one, only Shiva wanted, Shiva was not present when Mohini Murti, Vishnu, distributed nectar amongst the gods and the demons. Shiva heard it afterwards, and he was so much charmed with the description of the beauty of Mohini Murti that he came to the place later on when all things had finished, then Shiva prayed if I could have seen that beautiful Murti. Then when he went to Narayana and prayed for this, then suddenly he saw that beautiful woman figure as Mohini just appeared before him, before his eyes, before his, and he was so, and Shiva's wife was just on his side. But still, the wife in the side, that means the man must have some check, but he forgot himself that his guardian is there, forgot, and so much besides himself, he approached to catch her, but the Mohini Murti, that was a phantom, and that slipped away and then vanished. But she was so much excited that the semen fell from him, and wherever those semen fell, the sugar, no, the gold was produced thereby. It has been mentioned in Bhagavad. But not any possibility there was of union between Mohini and Shiva. No possibility. And Vishnu is always always Purusha, enjoyer, and not to be enjoyed anywhere. Intensely, substantially, he is always enjoyer and not to be enjoyed. That is Prakriti. We have never heard that Vishnu took the form of women. He is enjoyer, not to be enjoyed. Predominating mighty, not predominated mighty. Hare Krishna. Where have you found that?
In Kerala.
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 In
Kerala, where?
In
what place? Kerala.
It's all over Kerala, the temples of, Ayyappa.
Then, the ancient or recent?
They say ancient.
They say what? You had your experience.
He's talking it's Ayyappa.
Ayyappa. Ayyappa meant?
There's one particular.
Particular province?
Particular deity.
Ayyappa.
Deity called Ayyappa.
Ayyappa.
You must have heard it then, at that time. Also.
Where is it located?
All Kerala.
In what town?
Many places in Kerala.
Kerala.
Tamil Nadu. Many people worship Ayyappa.
Ayyappa. Ayyappa means the son of Vishnu and Shiva.
Yeah, I also saw that.
The main shrine is...
They're bogus.
Main shrine is?
The main shrine is Shabrimalaya.
I did not hear. I heard only that they take Vishnu as the brother-in-law of Shiva. Because in... Vrindavan from Yashoda, the twin, came Ashtabhuja Devi, to whom the Vasudev took to Mathura from Vrindavan, Ashtabhuja Murti, the sister of Krishna. Krishna was born and the Ashtabhuja Murti born. Vasudev took Krishna to Yashoda and took her son. So they say that Ashtabhuja Murti Katyayani, he was the sister of Krishna, and because Ashtabhuja is the wife of Shiva, so Vishnu becomes wife's brother, that is brother-in-law. In this way they represent Vishnu, the extreme section that that takes Shiva to be the highest god. Four sections of the Shiva worshippers are to be found in the south. Four sections. Pashupat, I forget the name. Four sections they are divided into. But I never heard here to that such one child has been... But I found the name of Nijolingappa. Nijolingappa. Whose appa means father, whose father is his own but who is his own father, Nijolingappa. He is father of himself. That is Nijolingappa. But it is Swayambhu. He has created himself. That is Swayambhu. By itself, of Hegel. He is by reality, by itself, Nijolinga. Hare Krishna. Maya Rakati, Mahaprabhu says that Sanatan Goswami, that Mahishi Haran, Kesavatar, Viruddha Vyakhan, that is all imagination to suit some purpose. What is that? What technically known? Mahaprabhu told, remarks. Asura Mohan. Just as Shankara was ordered that go and try to take away the general attention of the people against me, do away from me, Lokam Mad Vimukhan Kuru, that is, the unity of segregation in a hospital, the more serious patients are taken away to for the interest of the less serious patient. So this policy has been adopted, that the who are great offenders, serious offenders, more heinous, they should be secluded. There are all offenders, but more or less the most desperate should be separated to save the mild offenders. But the interest of the mild offenders, the grave offenders should be separated. So whose disposition is more atheistic, they should be separated from the wavering, hesitating public. So Madhavim Khan Kuru clear that I am God. Preach that. It has been said like that. Lokan Mad Vimukhan Kuru. What's the name you told?
Ayappa.
Ayya means Arjo. Appa means father.
Yes.
Ayar. Ar means Mahasaya. Ayya means father. Ar Pita Mahasaya. Ayappa, Ayya means father, Appa. Appa means also father, Ayya means father, Ayya. Both Pita, Ayappa. Something like that. Father of the father. Ayappa. The father of the father.
Ayya sometimes means big brother.
Many may come to this. Ayya appa, appa. Father. That is father's father. Ayappa.
বড় ভাই কে বলতে বড় ভাই তো আন্না
Anyhow, that Guru is born, Guru is born. Any concoction, a curious concoction. Oh.
was wondering, since today is Ekadasi, if you can tell us something about the importance of Ekadasi.
Ekadasi. Aprakrita. Aprakrita means which is like prakrita. Super mundane. Aprakrita. Which is similar to mundane but not mundane. That is aprakrita. Super mundane. The mundane color is there, so the word mundane is used. But we have to remind the warning that this is not mundane, though similar to mundane. So aprakrita. So we are told that Krishna Maharaj is very super mundane. So like mundane. Similarity with Vyasti, similarity of mundane. So as we find here that by the influence of the moon, here in this world, everything by the influence of the moon, the heat of the world, or the rosh means the watery portion in the body that increases in every place, in samudra, in ocean also, this jwar, ebb and tide. What is that? Ebb and tide.
Jwar. High tide, low tide. High and low tide.
High and low. So, in full moon and new moon, in nearing both these occasions, there the watery portion is swallowed, is enhanced, and thereby the enjoying spirit is also developed. I am talking it from the lecture of my Guru Maharaj in Kurukshetra, 1927. Basis, scientific basis, that by the movement of the earth, moon, planet and the sun, the heat becomes less and the exciting rosh, meaning the juice in our body is enhanced, and thereby it increases the tendency of exploitation, enjoyment. So, fasting is necessary to meet with that external movement of the nature. The fasting can save us from that peculiar reaction. So fasting has been recommended. And especially if one cannot fast at all, it is impossible, then he may take to some classes of diets that will give less cause for excitement. So umkalpa. And mainly fasting. Why? To check the senses. Because the senses at that time, by the natural flow, it becomes more intense, And the result is that he is excited and he wants to enjoy, to encroach on other, on the environment. So this unfair encroachment of one's own self to be controlled, this fasting has been recommended. This is one way. Another way, it is took to the center, the by in such season, the Krishna himself, he also felt more necessity of enjoying. And when Krishna feels more necessity, the devotees, they get a greater chance of service. The time is very valuable for them. The Krishna wants to enjoy. And at that time, devotees should be busy to supply his things for his enjoyment. So much so that they won't have any time to prepare themselves. Upo samipi vasa. Upo means samipi. Always to remain by the side of Krishna, for whenever and whatever he wants, only to supply. They forget taking their own food, etc., or any other thing. They want to be more busily engaged for the service of Krishna, because in the time of need, they will fetch more remuneration, that is, affinity towards Krishna, more grace. So, upas mipi vasa. And the secondary is to, by fasting, we can make our body dry. And so, our enjoying spirit will be lessened. These two. the general explanation. Then there are so many things that everything is contrast. Everything is personal. So Ekadashi has got her personal character, and she devotes herself for the service of Krishna with all accompanying them. And the service of Krishna engages her. And does not know any food or anything else. Does not allow others also in her group to take food and waste time, but always engagement with the service of Krishna on the line. Meaning is that. Am I clear?
Yes.
Why is then that we take some food and not other foods?
That I told.
Why we take?
That are less injurious. Those that are considered to be less injurious. Not more exciting. But that in that way it has been. And also it is mentioned in another way in Hari Bhakti Vilas. Some peculiar things. They are fond of taking their shelter in those places which we reject. A pap. Pap means a type of sin that are very fond of taking their shelter in those trees and those places which we surely want to avoid. It is mentioned like that.
Gaur Hari Gaur, Nidai Gaur Hari Gaur, Nidai Gaur Hari.
Maharaj,
yes?
Can you tell us also about the importance of Dwadashi? Can you tell us also about the importance of Dwadashi?
The importance of Dwadashi.
Yes. Ekadashi, Dwadashi, Purnima, Amavasya. So in the beginning, Dwadashi is more In another word, we are told, another aspect, approach, that Ekadashi, Dadashi, they are very favorite tithi of Holi. So, in that, the underlying cause already explained then. But it is told that these two tithis, they are very favorite to Holi. And in those tithi, if we serve Hari, Hari will be pleased with a smaller service. So Dadashi, Ekadashi, both are very favorite to Hari. So Dadashi has been called more favorite, but little lenient. So Ekadashi, only Ashtam Mahadadashi, then there we can live Ekadashi and we observe Dadashi. Otherwise, Ekadashi observance is compulsory. Compulsory. Though Dadashi is also honored and favorite of Hari, still Ekadashi has got preference for fasting. And only in the 8 cases, by the mixture of Nakkhatra, Tithi, etc., and the Dadashi has got the preference over Ekadashi. That is the time when our small service will give us a greater result. That is the clue, the key. As in Ekadashi, in Dadashi, if we serve, service is small, but we get some greater remuneration. Remuneration means his praise, pity, serving attitude, our honestness, all these things will be enhanced in that particular season. That the Hari wants to consume more from the service. So that is the fortune of the servitors, that the Hari demands more service. So the importance, for the servitors. At that time, during Ekadashi and Dadashi, less service of Hari is more useful. That is the key. Hari Krishna. Gaur Hari Gaur. And in the approach of Purnima Ramavasya, that rasa, that the material eccentricity of enjoying energy becomes comes to the highest degree. So check, in the beginning, the check before full moon and new moon, it is checked nearby. Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna.
Jawa.
Bhattanpurva.
Jawa.
Adur Jitsa Dharichi.
Hari Krishna, Gaur Hari, Gaur Hari, Gaur Hari. Nidai Gaur Hari Gaur.
It is a microphone that works, wireless microphone.
Oh, in any place it may be placed.
Anywhere.
I am told that one button, this button, was represented by America to Khrushchev, or from Khrushchev to American president. He was presenting this button to you, and it was there, and whatever they are talking of, reporting.
It is like that.
And in the second war, I was told that one Japani, half-mad sadhu, he was posted in Burma under a tree. He was a madman begging and spending his days in some meditation and etc. But he had a peculiar type of machine, something like in his hand, detected. And then it was found that he was a spy, a sadhu, but only what he speaks sometimes, this hand watch for us, and that is transmitted.
They think that we Western Vaishnavas, that we are from the CIA. They say that we are from the CIA.
They are of that mentality. Samashila Bhajanti.
Spies.
They are all a political mind. I was told that there was one leader of communistic thought previously, one Nipen professor. Nipen. When he came here, he also gave a lecture. And he told that I went to meet Bhavananda Maharaj. Mm-hmm. Swami Maharaj was present at that time. But he told you, Indians, you don't like, you don't want to put faith in God. It is very wonderful. You must put faith. And then you see whether he is or not. Beforehand you say, there is no God, no God. But come to see God in a process that has been recommended, then you will know. That gentleman told that professor here that I was not defeated by his arguments. But I could trace his simplicity, and that attracted me, the gentleman told. And I was told by another gentleman that he approached Bhavananda Maharaj, that we were all CIA, all these things. We wonder that in India you cannot think it that a man can exclusively devote his life for spiritual purpose. We have to see that in India, the land famous for its spiritual culture. So they are all, so it justifies our as the attitude of Guru Maharaj to approach the West. These are slave mentality. The Indians or Asians, they are more or less hankering after staring at European culture, civilization. So they are all slave to that culture, scientific civilization. So they should be approached, not these people who are always hanging up the grammar of present civilization, which is found in Europe and America, the Western country. So it is useless to approach these people, but rather we shall try to approach them. So they are all more or less political-minded, mostly political-minded. Can't see beyond politics. Politics. This body conception. Body conception. Though land famous for spiritual cultivation, but this Kali Yuga just the opposite. And so Mahaprabhu has come with the highest conception of spiritual. Spirituality, the highest degree of spiritual conception. He had to come to retaliate, to save the situation. The highest form of theism, a drop of the highest form of theism may be dealt with to these persons. Other medicines won't work. Only the highest type of medicine can work here. So, in some other ages also, men have got real sense. They aspire after a birth of, in Kali Yuga, apparently so unfavorable for spiritual life. So very unfavorable for spiritual life, this Kali Yuga. But still, Sarograhi, there are persons in any other yuga where apparently environment is more spiritual. They want a birth in this Kali. They are